I think an interesting question is, why Texas A&M? Why should Texas A&M invest in cancer research? And why should cancer research investments be placed at Texas A&M?
Many people in the field of cancer therapeutics and cancer biology feel this is a critical period of time where we should, in fact, be able to deliver important improvements in how we both diagnose and divide and recognize different subtypes of cancer, and then deliver much more specific and appropriate and effective therapies for those cancers.
What is also very, very clear is we are right now at an extraordinary time in science. And what is extraordinary about it is the dichotomy, if you will, from the fact that we are making advances daily, hourly, that we could not even have dreamt of 20, 30 years ago.
Unfortunately, cancer is not a disease. It's really many, many, many different diseases. And the fact of the matter is, even if two people are diagnosed with the same type of cancer, whether it be breast cancer or colon cancer, the fact of the matter is, they both have very different diseases. Cancer is very much unique to the individual that has it.
Up till just the past few years, we've relied almost entirely on the pharmaceutical industry to develop these important new tools for us for treatment. We have now built in our own laboratories and academic environments the ability to take molecules all the way up to clinical trials where we're putting them in humans.
There's a lot of emphasis in the cancer field to develop new drugs, which we call targeted drugs. They target something in the tumor to specifically shut it down, but it's targeted to the tumor and not the non-tumor tissue. So they're relatively non-toxic.
We have actually focused in on the drug-resistant cancer. So we're looking at our new molecule that we've gotten approval from the FDA to do clinical trials on is strictly for treatment of relapse cancer. So this isn't just a one-off drug. This is something that we think will have multiple indications for drug-resistant cancers in the future. So this is just the first of many. We made this molecule, we synthesized it, and did all the testing here. In fact, everything's been done here at Texas A&M.
We understand that we do better when we interact with our colleagues, and that we can do more as a team than we can as an individual struggling alone in the laboratory.
One of the key features of the research program that we put in place here at Texas A&M is the idea of assembling teams of investigators to tackle particularly large and difficult scientific problems.
And so part of my job not only is coming up with the ideas, but also is training these students, this next generation of cancer researchers. And at Texas A&M, unlike a lot of other institutions and medical schools, we're very dependent upon graduate students.
A lot of our graduates have formed companies. And others are consultants, others work in pharma and in many other industries. And, you know, they're already making contributions.
When you have a student coming in, they haven't been set in their ways yet, so they can come in with new ideas, new approaches. Sometimes they're crazy, and you try to tell them that, but sometimes they make big differences in a project in a very positive way.
Unlike a lot of other diseases, the odds of men and women getting cancer is, it's very high. There's a good chance that somebody, either a close friend or a family member, is going to be diagnosed with cancer. My mother was just diagnosed with breast cancer. I've been actively involved in it, but now it becomes personal in what you're wanting to do.
Now it's cancer's turn. Now we understand that what, in fact, are some of the opportunities. And so the emphasis at the moment on cancer research is to take advantage of the investment of time, effort, and talent that's gone into understanding basic cancer biology and to convert that into improvements in human health.